guys, long time no see. It's Jenna the Fashion General. And again, I'm so sorry. I have not been uploading every single week like it should be. It's just that I've been pretty busy. So anyway, this is gonna be like my first kind of video like this. So it's like a story time type of video. So I am just kinda gonna wing this. I've never done a video like this before. Now it's official. Can't back out, can't back out, no! Getting ready for the night of nights, the night of nights, alright. Don't panic, panic! Now do we have to dress up for... Well, my prom day, I woke up really early to get my prom corsage together because unlike a lot of people who have dates, their date would usually buy them the corsage, or they would like pick out their corsage with their dates. I went to prom with my friends, and a lot of people who have dates, they go to prom with their friends too, but for me, I didn't have a date to prom, and neither did some of my friends, so we all just decided to hang out together without dates at prom, and that was no big deal at all. Like, honestly, I didn't really want a date to prom. You know, it sounds weird, right? Like, a lot of people are like, oh yeah, I want a date to prom. But the thing was, I didn't have a boyfriend at the time when I was senior in high school. And it's like, ideally, I didn't want to have a date because I was afraid that I would be asked to prom by some random guy that I like, barely even know. So I didn't want that to happen to me. And I also didn't want to be asked by somebody that I don't even like. Like, I mean, there weren't that many people that I, like, disliked in high school. It's just that I really just didn't want to have to have a date to prom with somebody I didn't know well enough. I had a bunch of guy friends, actually, but they asked other people, and that's okay. And then it's funny, at one point, my mom's like, Jen, just ask somebody yourself. And I was just like, I don't want a date, though. And if I do have a date, it would be from this one person that I thought was going to ask me, but didn't. And they ended up not asking me, and it was no big deal at all. And, I kind of went off on a tangent. But anyway, so I got up early Saturday morning, June 6th, that was the day I had my prom, to get my corsages together, because I did my own DIY corsage. I thought I was going to film a video on how to make your own DIY corsage for this, at least to post this year, but I never got around to doing it. And that's not that bad, because then I could probably just save that for next year, when prom season comes again. Yeah, I just worked on my corsages that morning, and then I had my hair appointment scheduled at a local salon for 5 o'clock. My prom was from 8 till 11:59 that night. So I had my hair appointment scheduled for 5 o'clock, and I think that was a good time to have it scheduled, because I had plenty of time to get my hair done. But I really didn't know what I wanted for my hair for prom. I know that also sounds crazy because, like, I feel like a lot of girls, they, like, know everything they want, you know, down to every single detail that comes to prom. But for me, I was just like, I don't know. I don't know what I want for prom, for my hair anyway. So I just went in to my appointment, and then I was just like, to the hairstylist, I was like, I don't really know what I want for my hair for prom. You can just do whatever you think looks good. Just whatever you think would look good. I actually used the word whatever. She was just like, oh, well, I can give you an updo. And I was like, sure, yeah, I would love an updo. So I just turned me around and did her thing, and I got my hair done. So I had my hair She like pulled my hair back, and then she, it was like a curly type of thing going on. I don't really know exactly how to explain it, but I'll probably put some pictures, probably towards the end of this video, if not in the beginning, or a little bit of both, to show you what it looks like at prom. But, I saved the hairpins. She put these, hairpins in my hair for free. That was really nice of her. See, here's, let me go closer. Here's the hairpin that she put in my hair. She had like several of these in my hair. It was like a curly updo in the back. And it was really cute. I loved it. And it's pink. Oh yeah, and my corsage. I actually, since I made my own corsage, I used real flowers that I bought. And I also use a mixture of like fake materials too. It's funny because my mom, she saved some of the stuff she used for her wedding dress and her wedding decorations. She saved a box of it and she came across it and she's like, "Oh, Jen, would you like to use this stuff?" And I was like, "Yeah, sure." So it's been over a year since I've been to prom, so my corsage is, the flowers are dead, obviously, real flowers. So this was originally white, this was a white rose, and these two here are carnations. They were pink carnations originally, and then this was, these were forget-me-nots, these blue flowers right here. And this, I don't know what this was. This was actually taken from my backyard. So the real flowers that I have for my corsage, like I actually bought some from a store. Like the rose and the carnations I bought from a store. And the blue forget-me-nots, I don't know, shriveled up. And this one, this used to be like a white flower. These are from my backyard. And then this right here is a fake flower. It kind of popped off. Gosh, I don't think you can see this very well. Maybe if I put it against my black shirt, you can kind of see it. But it's, I don't know if this is supposed to, like, mimic some sort of real flower, but it's cute. It's white. And, like, the little pollen on it is, like, kind of pearly. Some pearly material. And this was, like, a little piece from, like, extra piece from my mom's wedding gown, I think, actually. Because she had to get it altered and cut some of it off, like the train or something. I think this is part of her dress, actually. And then this here was the wristlet that I tied to my wrist. So stay tuned for a DIY corsage tutorial sometime next year, probably. It's prom season again. And, so after I got my hair done, I went home and I got dressed, and you guys have actually seen my prom dress before in another one of my videos. It was in my Scream Queens lookbook. I wore it for Hester's, the character Hester's inspired look. So it seemed like my prom dress seemed like something she would wear, I don't know. Yeah, my dress is like a blush pink. I feel like it was a very trendy color when I went to prom. Okay, let me take it out. Yeah, and like I mentioned in my, I think it was like, prom dress hunting tips video, that I only got my dress for $79.20 because I got it for sale and it was kind of cheap to begin with, and so I was really lucky. See, isn't it pretty? I didn't go to prom not too long ago. I mean, I didn't go this year, but yeah, this is it's not like it's been a decade or something crazy like that since I've gone to prom, so I could definitely still fit this. See. Oh, I love it. Like, it just makes me so happy every single time I take it out. I remember the first time I brought my prom dress home after I bought it, I literally, like, put it on and I danced around the house because I was, like, alone and I was like, what the heck? I feel like a princess in this. And I was, like, so excited. So, yes, here it is. It has, like, little sequins on it, lace, blush pink, and then it has, like, a lot of detailing here on the bodice. Oh, I love, like, I love flowers and stuff, so. Yeah. I'm still in love with it, like, the day I bought it. Actually, I didn't buy it. My aunt actually, stepped forward and offered to pay for it, and it was super nice of her. Okay. Back. And show you my prom heels. I don't think you could see my shoes very well in my prom photos. I really like them too. And I also got my prom heels on sale because the store that I bought them in was closing down, so they had to get rid of everything. Okay, I'm not gonna lie, these are kind of dirty where my toe, like, you can see that it's dirty where I put my toes, and you know, it's kind of gross, but it's like, it's has this like glittery material here where you put your toes, and it's kind of like impossible to clean the dirt off of it because then the sparkles will come off and I'll ruin my heels. But here they are, like a beige, almost like a rose gold kind of. Yeah, and they like match my dress perfectly because although they're not blush pink, they're like a rose gold. They have lace here that like matches with my dress pretty nicely, and it has like silver sparkles and bling bling. I like my bling bling. I love sparkly stuff. If you haven't been able to tell. Yeah, so after I got my hair done, I got dressed, and I did my own makeup for prom. Because I didn't want to spend too much for prom, to be honest. And I'm really happy that I didn't, because I really don't think I really needed a makeup artist. I mean, it would have been nice, but your makeup professionally done can be expensive. And I'm not rich. I'm not poor either, but I'm not, like, rich where I can just, like, splurge on a bunch of expensive stuff, like, no problem. And I practiced doing my makeup by myself for like a month or something to figure out how, like, it's not, I didn't try every single day of the month, but yeah, I practiced doing my own makeup, and I went for a more like kind of natural but dramatic look at the same time. I don't know, I literally put on some bronzer, and then I used like a nice light pink lipstick, and the one thing about my look that wasn't so natural, that was kind of what made it dramatic, was I wore false eyelashes, and so that's why I would say it was a more natural but dramatic look. I don't know. So those are kind of opposites, but if you saw my makeup look, you would probably understand.
Don't panic! Now do we have to dress up for the prom? Dude, I don't think we have the choice.
Yeah, it's the night of all nights, gotta look just right, dressing to impress the boys.
Do I want classic or vintage or flat? Where's the mirror? I think this tux is too baggy, too tight, it makes me look